Welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing great. It's time for another video about Tachiyomi, the app that, according to me, is the best app for reading manga, manhwa and manhwa when it comes to Android. In today's video, I will explain all the reader settings that we can use while reading. So, let us begin. 3, 2, 1, go! In order to access the reader settings while reading, all you have to do is tap in the middle of the screen, just like this. On the top, we can see the name of the manga, the chapter number, and the bookmark option. By the way, I would suggest that you all read this manga. It's only 24 chapters long, but every single chapter is really satisfying to read. It's filled with hilarious moments, and the character development is also good. But the best thing about this manga is the cuteness of the characters that just washes away all your stress and helps you relax, if you're into that kind of manga, that is. Okay, let's get back on track. On the bottom, we have the page slider, the next and the previous buttons. Just below this are all the reading options that I will be explaining today. The first one to the left is the reading mode. Here you can select between 6 different reading modes. The first one is default. You can set any one of the other 5 reading modes as the default reading mode, and the best one among them is the webtoon mode. As for why I call the webtoon the best reading mode, I will explain it later. The next one is the left to right mode. In this mode, we can go to the next page by swiping from the right to the left, as you can see, and we can go to the previous page by doing the reverse. The next mode is right to left, which is the exact opposite of the previous mode, as you can see here. The next reading mode is vertical. In this reading mode, the next page is brought up with a bottom to top swipe, and the previous page when swiping from top to bottom. The fourth reading mode is the continuous vertical. This is the second best reading mode according to me. In this one, you can slide the screen up and down to go to the next and the previous page respectively, as you can see. This mode is only good when reading manga. But when it comes to manhwa and manhwa, this one has something which I personally do not like, and that is the black spacing between the chapter pages. I don't mind this black spacing when it comes to manga, but in case of manhwa and manhwa, it breaks the flow of reading. Here you can see how it affects the manhwa. Now I will show you guys why I call webtoon mode the best reading mode. Let me switch it up. See? Those annoying black spacings are now gone. And now we have a truly continuous reading mode without any disturbance. The next reader setting is this one. When you turn it on, this setting crops the borders of the page in case the manga has larger borders on the sides. I would recommend turning it on when the page borders start affecting your reading experience, otherwise keep it off. The next option is the screen orientation. When you tap on this option, it shows various ways in which you can orient the screen. The first one is default, which you can set in the settings. The second one is free. This means that the screen will rotate automatically according to your device orientation. The next one is the portrait, which keeps the manga in portrait mode. Similarly, there's the landscape mode, and then there are locked portrait and locked landscape mode. Though I have no idea why anyone would want to read manga in landscape unless you own something like the Galaxy Tab or the Galaxy Fold. The final reader mode setting is the setting. The first section of the setting has the reading mode options. Here, in the first part, you can set the reading mode and the orientation for this manga. Remember that it will only apply to this manga. For the others, you will either have to do it again or change the default reader settings in the more section of Tachiyomi. The second part has additional settings specialized for the different reading modes. When you apply the left to right or right to left reading mode, the paged settings are shown. In these, the available options are shown below. The first one is the navigation. This option changes how tapping on different places on the screen will have different effects in terms of next page, previous page, and opening the reader settings during reading. Here you can see that when I change the navigation mode to L-shaped, it becomes like this. when you tap on the screen with the green colored area, you will navigate to the next page. Whereas tapping on the other color will take you to the previous page regardless of which reading mode you are using. The middle area without any color will open the reader settings when you tap on that. You can select any of the options that you want, and after testing all of these, add the ones that you prefer as the default one. The next is the invert tapping. This would do exactly as its name means. It will invert your tapping on the screen. Tapping on the top will now take you to the next page, while tapping on the bottom will take you to the previous one. The next option is the scale type, which can change how the pages are shown on the screen. I would recommend not changing it and keeping it to fit the screen of your device. Next is the zoom start position. Just keep this setting the same as it is provided by default. Now we have the crop borders that I have already explained, and the dual page split, which doesn't really do anything yet. When we change the reader mode to Webtoon or Vertical, the only thing that happens is that this name here changes and the scale type and zoom start position become unavailable. An option that becomes available when we change the Webtoon mode is the side paddings. We can change the percentage of the side paddings in this option, and you can see what the results are. I don't like this setting, so I just keep it off. The next section we have is the general settings. These are the ones which I don't think I really need to explain, just enable them all. Finally, we are at the most complex settings that many of us will not even use, even if we know how to. The first option is the color filter, which you can enable if you want to play with the colors, I guess. You can enable this setting and change the sliders any way you want to in order to get the required colors, if you want, that is. The next one is the color blending options. This one works in conjunction with the color filter. The next one is the grayscale. Enabling this will change the colored manhua and manhwa into grayscale. After this is the inverted option, which will invert all the colors, and here is what a manhua look like when their colors are inverted. Believe me, it does not look good. The last option is the custom brightness, where you can change the brightness for only the manga and not the device itself. That's all for the reader settings which are available while reading manga in Tachiyomi. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching this video. See you next time.